There are just four people left in the jungle, as last night we saw Steve Price voted out, and he joins us now from Africa. Hey, Steve, welcome to the show.
Thank you, Sarah. Great to be with you.
We are now at the pointy end of the competition. I thought you'd win the thing. Are you disappointed that you didn't make it the whole way?
No, I'm not disappointed. How could you be after lasting 6 weeks? It's actually 6 weeks today that we went into that camp down there, and I think that's a pretty amazing effort. The five of us sat around the jungle fire, which I hope's still alive, by the way, because I've been the main man keeping it alight. We sat around the fire this morning and we all shook hands and said, no matter who goes, it's no big deal, no big drama. We've done everything. I've done everything I could possibly do. I've lost weight, I've jumped off bridges, I've had foul-smelling stuff tipped on me. I've ate rubbish that would kill a normal man and kill a dog. So why would I be disappointed about going 2 days before? I'm not disappointed at all. Was I desperate to get out of there? Look, I'm desperate to reconnect with the real world, but no, I'm not disappointed. How could you be? I mean, all of those people left, the four people left in the camp, Nat, Dane, Casey and Nazim, any of them would be a worthy winner. I just hope that the best man or woman is crowned king or queen of the jungle when it happens.
Well, you were very entertaining to watch. Now, when Kira entered the show, you seemed to become a little more grumpy. What was it about her that pushed your buttons?
Well, Joe, I'm not that grumpy. I think I've shown in the show that I can actually be quite a kind, warm, gentle, loving, funny, humorous, intelligent and smart man. But yes, you can characterise me as grumpy Joe if you wish. But Kira did push those buttons because Kira was an annoying person. She was a bogan and she just had an annoying laugh and kept talking about herself. Now, when you're in an enclosed space 24 hours a day and you can't get out, I mean, the only place to escape is go and sit in the long drop, which wasn't very pleasant, or go down and have another shave, and I had two a day. So, Joe, when someone gets into my space that really annoys me, and look, Kira, if you're watching this, it's nothing personal, I just don't like you.
Yeah, that is what a grumpy person would say. Hey, Steph, you said you wanted to show older people can break bad habits they may have. What bad habits were you hoping to break?
Richard, I think we all like you. I mean, look at you, Richard. I mean, in the old days, you were a fine figure of a man. You're now just a former shadow of yourself. Look at you, mate. You look dreadful. But look, I have stopped drinking. I've given up fast food. Not that I was a big fast food fan. I was force-fed chocolate in there when I didn't really want it. I'm actually now exercising. Look at what walking to the wood drop and back every day for the last 6 weeks does. It drops that beer gut off. Now, the challenge is, and I'll be kept honest by my weekly appearances, I guess, on the project, the challenge is to keep it off, look young. But on a serious note, Richard, you should try this yourself. I think this show, and I'll say it to anyone who asks me over the next couple of months, this show has put 10 years, without exaggeration, on my life. No doubt about that for one moment. And the first thing I do when I get back to Australia, I'm going to go to my doctor and say, hey, how good do I look?
Yeah, looking great, Pricey. Pricey, it's me, Pete. Did you miss me?
Peter, where have you been, mate? Have you missed me would be the question. How lonely are Monday nights without me on the desk for you to bounce those bad jokes of yours off? And I've got a present for you, Pete. I'm not going to tell you what it is, but I only packed three things from that tepid camp that I've evacuated in the last 24 hours. And one of them's for you, mate. One of them's for Waleed. And one's for Carrie. You're going to have to wait till I get back on the project, but you're going to be so excited, Pete. I've bought you a present, and you're going to treasure it for the rest of your life.
Oh, I'm a little bit nervous about that, to be honest.
Now, you struck up an unlikely bromance with Nazim. Would you ever consider doing a radio show with him?
Jess, I think it was an unlikely pairing. You're quite right. Whether we team up and do a radio show, I find that probably a little hard to believe. Certainly, I think Nazim and I were placed in there and everyone presumed that we would have arguments constantly. We only had one a week, which was nice. He made a ridiculous comment in the final week of the show that I was there that I won't even revisit because I think I'll have to re-educate the boy when he gets out. But I treated him a bit like a son. He's like a naughty little brother, but for me he was like the son I never had, really. I'm going to actually really connect with Nazim when he gets out. He has promised. And he's about to appear at the Melbourne Comedy Festival. Anyone who'd like to buy tickets, just get online and Google up Nazim. You can find where to buy them. I'm giving him a plug. He wants to fill seats at his comedy show. You know why? because I'm going to get up and tell some gags at Nazim's comedy show at the Melbourne Comedy Festival. How much fun will that not be?
How come you won't do that at my gigs, Pricey?
Pete, you're not getting me for free. No, only Nazim. If you want me, Pete, you're going to have to pay me.
Well, Steve Price, we have certainly seen a very different side to you over the past 6 weeks. You've been fun to watch. Thanks for joining us.
Pleasure, guys. No problem. I love Studio 10. And anytime Joe Hildebrand takes a holiday, I'm happy to come in and sit in his chair. I know I won't be as entertaining as Joe, but, you know, give an old bloke a break.
Pitching for gigs, Pricey. And Joe's actually just had a daughter, actually. Little Bonnie Rose was born on Wednesday.
Congratulations, Joe, to you and your wife and Bonnie Rose. You know I love your brother. And I'd love to come and have a chat to you on the desk, guys, anytime you want me.
All right, Steve Price, thank you so much.
Cheers.
And I'm a Celebrity. Get Me Out of Here continues Sunday night at 7 on 10 and Win.